Today we're going to use the Moore CT100B to find distance to cable fault. Let's get started. Always remember to properly discharge static before connecting to any high-frequency test equipment. And never connect to live equipment. First, we need to set the velocity of propagation, or VP. The accuracy of the distance to fault measurement depends on this value being accurate. This is the fraction of the speed of light that electricity travels in this cable. You can get this number from your manufacturer in the CT100B file function, or you can set the VP manually. I'm a trust but verify type person, and we've just touched on the first two. They are valuable references and great starting points, but if you want the most accurate VP, you really want to find it manually. After that, you can save it directly to your CT100B for easy recall later. We're going to start with one of our test cables. Using a standard tape measure, we can see that our cable from end to end is exactly 3 feet or 36 inches. Then we're going to subtract half of the last connector from that measurement, so now we're measuring 35¾ inches. Now we're going to connect the cable to our TDR after shorting the cable to disperse any static. Now we'll press the orange AutoFit Help button and select AutoFit from the menu. This will make the cable we are testing visible within the window, and cursors will be placed at the beginning and near the end of the cable. Notice the appearance of the end of the cable when we're adding the shorting cap and how it changes. This is how we know that we are at the end of the cable and that it's not damaged somewhere in the middle. And using our scale and position knobs as seen here, we're going to zoom in and on and position the second cursor at the end of the cable. Again, we'll show you what it looks like up close when we play with the end of the cable there. And add a short cap. Notice how the length of the cable changes when we add the short cap. Any component that we add to the cable is going to add length to the cable. Again, this is how you know you're at the end of the cable. An important note, a TDR measures in time, the time it takes to get to the measurement and back, and this is how we come up with the equation of distance over time equals velocity of propagation, or VP equals D over T. Next, we'll select Adjust VP under the M function, first using Coarse, then using the M function button to toggle to the fine options to adjust the VP till the measurement shows our predetermined length of 35¾ inches. And as I'm adjusting, you'll see that the time stays constant. We're not adjusting the length of the cable. We're adjusting the variable to make the equation match to what has already been physically measured. Now we can see our VP here, and it's rather close to the pre-programmed value stored in the CT100B, just more exact for this brand or even batch of cable. We can even save this VP reading to the CT100B for use later. Now let's connect a shorter cable. Keeping with electrostatic discharge procedures, we'll disconnect the first cable and try our shorter cable and see what it shows. Now we'll place our cursor at the end of the new cable, and we can see our cable length right here, and it's based on the VP that we've determined here. and we can verify our physical measurement here. Now we're going to scale things up a bit. We have a 1,000-foot roll of RG6 coax. We're going to see what it looks like on the CT100B. We've already determined the VP to be 0.85. Using the AutoFit function, it's going to change our measurement range from short to medium. As you can see here, it looks rather different compared to our shorter length of cable. There's a gradual rise with a sharp tick up at the end. And now let's see what that looks like with a short cap. And we're going to place the cursor at the end. And there you have it. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more updates. If you have additional questions, please feel free to check out our website at moretm.com or reach out to us via phone or email. And we'll see you next time.